Good evening, everyone. Good evening, soccer lovers. This is Number 10 Sharp Eye Channel. We are here, you know, to talk about PSL updates. Hopefully, you can hear me there. If you can hear me, please let us know if you can hear us. But if you can hear us, it's okay. Thank you very much for joining us. With me here, I'm with Iniesta. He'll introduce himself to everyone there. And yeah, thank you very much for joining us, my brother. How are you?
Sure, my brother.
Sharp man.
I hope you're good.
I'm very good, man. Thanks, man.
Just tell me
your name, where you come from. And
yeah. Dumela. Good evening. I hope by now you know me. Galibito, Ezekiel Iniesta Maupie, the sports technocrat. I'm part of Number 2010 Sharp Eye. I believe you're going to enjoy our conversation tonight. Yeah, arguing a part of the conversation. You can also or question and anything to do with soccer. So let's engage.
Yesterday it's only launching. There was a launch, Betway Premiership launch. I expected more.
But I
received less.
I'm disappointed, my brother. Yeah, I'm disappointed. Yeah. To be honest, not expecting a lot from Betway Premiership because the new sponsors, Dr. Ivan Kozo, the Red Miracles, are these are those guys on board.
Yeah, within few months.
And we all know DSTV Premiership is Lothar Maya. So I was disappointed, Mama. I know the only thing, a lot, to be honest, by announcing it, get the motto, the slogan.
Just the slogan.
That slogan. So, can't you, Lore, reward, Mama? And the other thing, a lot, will check the league CEO, Mayor Mato Matlada, or the players. Must not bet more on a Betway Premiership.
I
remember the story of Super Chain.
Yes, I remember.
It's a lot trend lately.
But at least I think later on they said it was not, you know, real or like he was betting and all that. But yeah,
the Orlando Pirates, they confirmed me, right? So I believe players will learn from that because remember, go EP, a lot of players, values just ban some of the Baba suspended because of that thing. Remember, Ivan Toney from Brentford, the last time Bamu suspended for 8 months, Katavane or better against his own team. I believe our own players, they are learning that thing. So, Mara, going back to Tabaya launch, it was disappointing, my brother.
Too much.
Never know you could push out Tabaya the coach because never you could introduce those 16 coaches,
PSL. Yeah.
But I was happy to see most of coaches or giddy local coaches. Most of them, they are local coaches. I saw Putimu Hafe, Logan City coach.
Yeah.
I saw coach Clinton Lassen, Magazi coach.
Magazi coach.
I also coached Steve Parker, Stellenbosch. Also, Musa Bilangulu was
the assistant coach.
The
same as Bernard Parker also.
And Bernard Parker.
TS Galaxy.
And also,
Leboga
Manyama. Because coach Tingla Nakasita, because remember, Onal Matata. So, there were a lot of PSL coaches. And also, only foreign coaches, Kiwane coach Nabi from Kaiser Chiefs.
That was interesting,
Also, coach Sidrama Bukinaro met Bernard Parker. Also coach Gavin and coach Mangwaba Mwiti. So it's a good thing over the local coaches are not the dominator. Molly Kieroyako, and I just hope, and also Denden Malasela
was there also,
For Maruma Gallants,
even the one for Skukune,
Little Ronola Sema, and it was good thing for media yesterday.
Too much.
All eyes, they were on Coach Nabi. All eyes were on Coach Nabi yesterday.
Exactly.
So it's a good thing, but I'm disappointed. Or, Betway, I launched our trophy, the new trophy.
The new trophy.
I want the new trophy. The prize money league or a league you dhalla bokae, and then even the other teams you grab bokae, and obviously
even the grant, ne?
The grant,
exactly. Yeah.
Remember the teams need to grab 2.5 from DSTV Premiership. Monthly grant was 2.5 million, and for multiple championship they were getting 500k.
Exactly. Yeah.
So I believe I was expecting more. What are both are the team do ground ma 5 million ka grant cover ma 5 million. So I was disappointed. Mara, let's just wait, we'll see. Cause no it's a countdown, like the league is starting in 10 days time. So
yeah,
we'll
yeah.
see.
No, now I was expecting a lot from the launch. And you know, one of the outstanding things that I was expecting is for the fans. You know, we are fans also, and I was expecting that, you know, they'll also announce Hori, what are they going to do for fans?
Yes,
you know, fans that are coming to the stadium every game, and what is the cause? We have seen with APSA, we have seen also with DSTV where they were, you know, fans were winning millions. You know, I think last year with DSTV they were winning 100,000 and 250,000. Hopefully that, you know, Betway this season will give fans also, you know, something to go home smiling. You know?
Yeah, let's just wait and see. The time Lord Bato announced, everyone, now on site, the media, I had Dr. Evin Koza, the time I announced, sorry. You, the members of media, you are going to benefit from this. Let's just wait and see. The CEO of Betway, Mr. Michelle, or on board. So, I just believe Ori, our viewer at home, you can ask any question regarding Betway. Some of things Mr. Ngobo, 2010 will mention them.
No, thank you once more for everyone who just joined us, and we can see
Ori. I see Moloko Luki.
Yeah.
And I also see Martinos.
Martin Martin. Motua,
yeah, colleague.
No, nice to have you on board.
Yeah.
We're just going, you know, to update you. It's gonna be a weekly thing that we're going to do. We also have a YouTube channel, you know, 2010 Sharp I channel. Please go there and subscribe there. To subscribe, you just click the subscribe button for free. You don't have to pay anything, and also follow this channel, which is number 2010 Sharp I. We are also on Twitter, number 2010 Sharp I, also on Instagram, number 2010 Sharp I. So, my brother, I think we just have to, you know, wrap it up. Betway launch, you know, as much as, you know, we are saying, like, we expected a lot, however, we didn't get what we wanted.
Yeah.
You know, one thing that I've heard, I heard you, you know, mentioning in the Abaya Cup, the trophy. I heard the marketing manager of Betway saying that they are going to create the new one. I think they are working with there's a designer that they're working with. They're going to, you know, combine all the previous cups that have been won by the previous teams. Hopefully, you know, it's gonna be something exciting that we're gonna enjoy, you know, to see. And remember, the DSTV Premiership, you know, was won by only Mamelodi Sundowns.
On a team young win a trophy.
Exactly.
And I believe that trophy already by Philo Mamelodi Sundowns.
Yeah,
I think they won it more than
seven times.
I mean
more than three times. So
yeah, more than three times, because they won APSA Premiership more than four times. And then DSTV Premiership. Obviously, this year, Nenje Baba Fayo na official.
Exactly. No, going forward, my brother, I think now that, you know, Betway starting next week on the 14th.
In 10 days' time.
In 10 days' time. Kaizer Chiefs is playing Marimo Gallants. I know Kaizer Chiefs fans have been waiting for their team to play.
It's been a very long time. The last time they played it was on 28 August, Toyota Stadium.
Exactly.
Toyota Cup,
It wasn't an official game anyway. It was just a friendly game. But the official game that they played, the PSL, was back in May. It has been a long time.
And against Cape Town Spurs, the time they lost.
To Cape Town Spurs, and Cape Town Spurs was already relegated by then. But then, looking at, you know, this season, Kaizer Chiefs has signed a lot of players, about seven players that they've signed. They've also brought in the technical team, you know, led by Coach Nabi. Do you think Coach Nabi is going to turn the tables at Kaiser Chiefs?
Yeah, it's not going to be easy for Coach Nabi. Obviously, the guy came with his own technical team.
Yeah.
Recorded Coach Nabi. Remember, go team Adam Kozona. He won a lot of trophies. Remember, Okoji Jago Pedro Di Luanda.
Yeah.
And also, as Farad, the last team he coached.
Yeah.
He won triple there and upper lucky league. Number two.
There's also the cup, the trophy that he played against Zimbabwe.
Yeah, against Coach Joseph Zimbabwe, yeah. Former Orlando Pirates coach. So I believe the guy, although the changes did in Chico Kaiser Chiefs, it's not going to be easy for him.
Yeah.
But what I can say, Coach Nabi, obviously profile like Blenna record high and Kaiser Chiefs.
Yeah.
The way relating before, it's a big team, it's a big brand. Obviously, defense, the expector. Once you come on board, obviously, but need a win.
Exactly. Like
nothing
yeah.
else they need
and
to
Kaiser
win.
And Kaiser Chiefs fans are hungry.
They are hungry, yeah, my brother. It's been 10
time.
Years. No, it's been 10
long
years.
Time, yeah.
So I believe Coach Nabi will do well, go Chiefs. And I believe Uto Akawina, I know most of fans say,
yeah.
I believe Trophy Nyane won Uto Wakayon.
Yeah.
And I believe the Kalim Black Label won on NetBank. I think he will do miracles. And even local leaking, I think the guy will do well.
Yeah,
I think,
do well.
I'm not saying our Coach Nabi will win the league, but I believe Coach Nabi will do well. And a good thing, Kubilele preseason team
exactly.
from day one.
Exactly. And he's the one who's acquiring
all the players.
The players.
All of them, yeah. So, any excuse, or Akare, what? Ubilele preseason the whole team.
Yeah.
And even the technical team,
exactly.
Remember, Coach Nabi was supposed to be Kaiser Chiefs coach guard the season, 2023-24 season.
Yeah.
And they had to bring Mlifintsiki.
Yeah.
So it was a bad thing for Kaiser Chiefs fans. And remember, the guy was doing well that time. So he even brought his own players, the likes of Mikel, which
yeah.
I believe the guy an excuse or I bring one or two trophies to Kaiser Chiefs.
Yeah, thank you very much for joining us. Martin Motwa is saying, "Ngethemba ngingenile kwangcoba, ngenile putu, ngenile phakathi inside." Luki Moloko Moloko. We are within Iniesta. Hashtag Iniesta.
thank you.
Yeah, the famous one. talking about Nabi, I heard him yesterday. You know, Coach Nabi, he's one of the coaches that are well known.
Yes.
Respected
yes.
all over Africa. And, you know, what I liked about him, he is confident.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
To the viewers, please go to our website. I've written a story about Coach Nabi, what he said yesterday. Website is www.novo2010sharpeye.com. Then you'll see the full story there. There he said he's here to take Chiefs back to where they belong.
Yeah, to the glory days.
And he also mentioned that he doesn't want to sign players who won't take Chiefs anywhere.
Yeah.
He doesn't deal with mediocre. And also... He turned down
the
top striker from Portugal because of he saw her like it doesn't suit the style of
the
Chiefs.
The style of Chiefs, yes. Kiko Jelo Chiefs he talk all along. And remember, the president Kaiser Chiefs, the chairman Mutaung senior on said or Kaiser Chiefs will struggle ka the black coaches. I believe Mantswal is interesting. I remember all the coaches who came after Stuart Baxter, they've been struggling.
Yeah.
So now it's a new white man, only in charge of Kaiser Chiefs. If you can check the history of Kaiser Chiefs, not responsible for race or anything, but if you check all those white coaches called Kaiser Chiefs,
most of them, they did good
football. Mar. Most of them, but with the trophy.
They won.
They won trophies.
Even back then, Philip Trozier.
Yeah. Paul Doleza. The late Dimitri.
The late Dimitri also. You know, they really played a very good
role. Lately, even the likes of Vivi, Vladimir
Vemezovic. Exactly,
it's only Solinas who failed.
That one.
I remember he was at Free State Stars. So, Mara, going to a question, Nabi. Nabi will do well, my brother.
Yeah.
Without a doubt, I believe it's just up to the players already coming to the party and they perform. They want to the Kaiser Chiefs Football Club.
Yeah.
Unexcused or Western team. Ask a winner.
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
Kaiser Chiefs fans, they must not expect a lot. I know they are hungry, man.
Hey, big time.
They must be patient with the guy. The guy, I believe, at least one trophy, Kiona, Ikachancha, Matata, Kaiser Chiefs.
Yeah.
Because to be honest, Kaiser Chiefs right now, Abanidure, Vajalev, good football, Abanidure, Babe number two on the lock. They just need one trophy.
Exactly.
Or a situation I want
to
change.
And also to honor Dr. Kaiser Mtaung. Remember, there's been a long time since he.
The guy has done a lot for the team. And I believe right now, I believe we deserve a honorary or something. And the Kaiser Chiefs on the market, they're doing all they can.
Big time.
Or a club by Ive Sharp. I know we have criticized those Mtaung guys, especially. Kaiser Mtaung Jr. because it's the SDA team.
Yeah.
Even also the likes of Bobby and Jessica. We all know Jessica is doing good for the marketing.
Marketing, yeah.
Yeah, sponsor as well. But because every time marketing or Chiefs pop up and Vadra good, some of the fans they get angry. Chiefs focus your more business or anything.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. Yeah.
Mara, I believe Kaiser Chiefs obviously is a big brand. Or like Vapatelet Plara, Demeter, and everything. They need to do good go marketing first,
exactly.
Which is a good thing. That's why when GCA Kaiser Chiefs and whenever on a game, level like game lately against Young Africa go to
Bloemfontein, yes.
Like my marketing like that game, and I believe they make a lot of money out of that game. So it's up to the players right now and the technical team or but bring something to the table. Kaiser Chiefs. It's a must. They must win a trophy this season.
Yeah.
Or else they'll never fade.
Exactly. Hopefully they are gonna win something. Cause you know it has been a disappointment for the past 10 years. Nabi is here, and then hopefully he's gonna change the tables.
Yeah.
But then going forward, Orlando Pirates are one of the teams you know that have been doing well.
Yeah. The Sea Robbers
have been robbing.
Yeah.
Everyone out there. Kaiser Chiefs.
When you say they've been robbing, someone is thinking of Abongile Tom.
No, they are playing very well with the
and they are winning fans square.
Yeah. But then on a coaching point of view, I think they've scouted a great coach.
Plumber.
Yeah,
one of the best.
They used to call him a plumber.
Yeah. Africa, everyone in Africa, plumber.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, I remember when I did story the trend. Paper this guy came to me again. I look at
oh yes, yeah.
Yeah. So, I believe Orlando Pirates they signed a good coach. Only proved in 2 seasons in a row. Oh, more DSTV Premiership.
Yeah.
More Premier Soccer League. Coach Jose. From Spain, the Spanish guitar. So the guy would really change his day by Orlando Pirates. Even the guy won 5 trophies in 2 seasons. So how is Oro Kaidir and Tricky? We all know got the season 2010-2011. Orlando Pirates, that was the last time they won double triple under coach Rudy Kroll. So now the guy, he reminds me of Coach Rudy Kroll, Coach Jose. So the guy, to be honest, is doing good, without a doubt. Good, And those fans about the guy as a winning league, Sanchez Amai, I have a little problem.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Coach Jose right now is one of the best coaches in the league. Unfortunately, Obale Chigu in a coach of the season.
Exactly.
Coach
Ashraf Rilan.
So, because normally, more like you're not Premier Soccer League.
Yeah.
Who selected as a best coach, normally, level la league. So, the system is a format of a shumishan.
Yeah, but Lohona, you know, that criteria, I think it's unfair.
It's unfair.
Because remember, a few years ago, Peter Musimane won a league. Benny McCarthy won the coach of the season.
Yeah,
but he didn't win the league.
But he
won the coach of the season. That's when he was coaching AmaZulu. Exactly.
Yeah.
You understand? But then anyway, this is a topic for another day. But then I just hope that you know the judges out there they can just look at this thing, Jorge. Orlando Pirates has won a lot of money last season domestically.
Two
because
trophies.
There's two trophies, and now if you can remember, MTN 8, it was eight million
that time,
and Nedbank Cup is 7 million.
7 million.
Eight plus seven is 15 million.
And they finished number two on the log.
You get
my
point.
They qualified for CAF.
Yeah, I understand. It's a lot of money. It's more than 20 million rand. Whereas Mamelodi Sundowns has won only the league, which is 15 million. So if we can't count AFL because of it's something that is outside South Africa, but then if you can take into consideration, Jorge, the coach made sure Jorge, he brings money in the team. He also brought, you know, he also built, you know, young players. Look at what he's doing with
Mufokeng.
He brought Bolibito.
The unknowns, not the like even Masongan.
Exactly.
He was a star superspot, Mar, not the way Dalaga or Number Pirates.
People didn't like Makopa, but you know,
Makopa,
he has been there. Makopa went to the
look at the look at Sipoche.
Ah, my brother.
No, he's one of the best goalkeepers.
Exactly.
So the spirit is a lot so now go fight spirit anyone. Go the Bucs TV.
Mm-hmm.
Go Bucs Camp, Orlando Pirates Football Club. Or the guy into IT City and go Orlando Pirates is big. So I believe it's a topic for another day.
Yeah. But then like I'm just happy that, you know, Jose came there as a foreign coach and he made changes. You know, I've got a problem with foreign coaches who comes to South Africa and they are respected by the chairman and the media, but then they are not delivering.
But no add that number.
They add numbers. Yet, South African coaches,
they are performing
very well. Sometimes you lose two games, then you are fired. You understand? Look at, for instance, I wanted us to also touch on coach Lesono Losiema. Away Skukuna United.
Yes.
Skukuna United, I think they were, first time they came to the PSL, they became number seven. Yeah, on the log. I think number six.
Yeah.
And then they went
they
on to number seven.
For top eight.
Yeah. And then this season they went on to number four. You understand? And then he was fired.
Got the last two games.
You get my point.
And he did well at Lesono Losiema. I believe the chairman there now did a lot undermine
South African coaches.
And especially when a low level profile. Sometimes it's not about profile or anything. Yeah. Kids can say a lot right now, but that time was did a good team. Lesono Losiema was doing good goals Kukun United. And remember, I did good go Polokwane City.
Exactly.
So the guy who deserve a contract. Now could just no contract go Skukuni. So I'm happy now Skukuni simu file
three years
contract and honor one or no.
Yeah.
But I'm celebrated the guy. So I believe the chairman and especially it's very painful. Our own chairman, our black chairman.
Exactly.
So,
you know.
Into a lot, it's very disappointing. Our black coaches, Rasa, defeat the respect. A lot of Sanche, look at the coach, a lot of Nefitine, media, a lot more.
Exactly.
A ball from school.
And he even left without touching the ball. Exactly.
Yeah. You know, Mara, please, left and right. So. It's very disappointing, my brother. It's very disappointing.
Yeah.
Mara, I believe the chairman are not the learner from this. I'm happy got the way. Even some people were arrogant. Chairman, Chairman Joni, what is it?
The guy,
he's loyal to his own people. Look at Cheka. Look at Coach Putimuhaf. Very underrated. Mara, the guy is doing good for.
Very good. Sundowns struggled to beat him.
Sundowns in the struggle. And Okacheka, one of the guy even finished go top eight.
Top eight, exactly.
So, and I also believe the guy is coaching without a contract to go to Polokwane City. Get the way.
Yeah.
Normally, this chairman is very loyalty. So, I know. Remember that phone call? That phone call
gave me a Sundowns.
So to Lord, I know if I can call this coach, he will answer and come to represent him or replace him.
And unfortunately, in such situations, us as fans, fortunately, the camera caught him on camera.
Yeah.
But then, us as fans, when he loses, even though he was instructed to do whatever that was instructed to do, When he loses, we want him to go.
Yeah, yeah. We don't care. These coaches are going through, my brother. So, and especially from the chairman. Yeah. Not all these coaches. These coaches. It's only the black coaches.
Exactly, yeah.
It's only the black coaches. So, I believe our chairman can do better. Remember the story of Chiba United, chairman Chiba Mbengezi. A controller, the coach. I remember.
Big time, yeah.
Coach Denden.
Yeah,
nearly teabag, not like nearly in and out.
In and out, yeah.
So
yeah.
It's very painful when the black
even
coaches,
the late coach here,
Skakan.
He used to be like that.
And
also,
remember, the guy promoted Chiba United,
exactly,
and even promoted Tandarwazu.
Yes.
So the guy was good to go during the time of Chiba and Tandarwazu, but chairman they are the most strikish. So, but I believe they can do better.
The same as Coach Mamila also, you know, he was in and out of the problem with South
Mr.
African
Pound.
Yeah, Mr. Pound. The problem with South African football is that coaches become friends with
the chairman. Yeah, yeah.
And they, even when they fire them, they can call them anytime they come back. And anyway, there's no way that he can say no, I'm Funuguza and all that.
And you mentioned someone, Mr. Ngobo, Coach Mamila, Mr. Ponto Pont.
Yeah.
The guy ke motoko office. I don't think the guy is a coach.
He must be a
Sanchabe is good as a CEO.
Or a CEO, exactly.
Oh, man, this guy is a CEO.
I remember when he was at Baroka.
Ah, the guy named Stylings. He was doing good as a CEO. Even Baroka won Telkom knockout.
Yes, yes, against
the time he was CEO.
Yes.
And Ele. Remember, he's the one who brought Miranda.
Oh, yes.
Miranda and Bushimuloi, the people's coach from TUT.
Yeah.
And he even brought Matsimela Talk. This thing, Yako coach is Baroka Itoka on a whole, 2012.
Yeah.
So, those 2016, those guys, they did well. Under Mr. Ponto Pound, CEO that time.
Yeah.
So, Mara, no, can't tell our different. Le Mr. Patel,
exactly, yeah.
So whenever I'm in,
and
leader,
also with Chiba also,
even Chiba, if I suspend, no, remember, no, he's only left with 58 points. Remember, like, only 60 points. No,
I
he
think
played
it's,
two.
I think it's 59 points because he only got
one. He got one point. He lost
point.
Another
yeah,
one.
He lost another one. He drew at home.
He drew against Obid.
Obid, yeah.
And, yeah, I believe.
Same
I
game. Just lost now. I think it's four. Yeah.
Hey, so I don't think the guy will survive. Even though chairman it's a must or a win.
It's a must. Yeah, I think he was given 5 games.
Yeah.
It's just that like the chairman didn't want to put it straight. He said he's talking to other coaches outside.
Yes.
I remember he was interviewed by Lerato Pago earlier on.
Yeah, yeah.
And then she gave him, you know, she put him under pressure, to mention the coaches. And then one of the coaches was from Cape Town.
Championship.
So you can see that, you know, I'm a Zinyaka, I'm Shilelis. But I think tonight we're on Betway Premiership.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
But just to touch on NFD, the coaches need to be respected. Even in the Betway Premiership, we hope that, you know, our coaches are respected. Look at, for instance, coaches like Eric Tinkler.
Yeah.
Has been there forever.
John Comiso has been loyal to the guy.
You understand?
He's been doing the job for Cape Town City.
Stephen Barker has been there.
Yes,
you understand,
yes,
and he's doing very well, and he's one of the coaches that I wanted us to touch on, especially the fact that, you know, he's been losing players every season. And he has been promoting players every season. You know, his boys, in the DDC Cup, I think three years back they won the league. Yeah,
they even won. That cup,
Yago
Premier League. This is the second time but winner trophy. Those
exactly.
boys, they are doing good.
Yeah.
So, Steve Parker, Ulusa de Plara, every season. Remember, two seasons back, he lost the Priest to Chiefs.
To Priest, yeah.
Now he
Winiga,
lost,
also lost
even,
Winiga.
And Winiga was the best center back.
Yeah, was the best center back, yeah. He also lost Tetwa.
He lost Mteto. Yeah.
So this season is Van Rooyen is gone.
Reynas
is gone. You know, you can see Uti, he's building. He still
and
have a tight task. I think Van Vick is gone. Eh?
Yeah, Sweden or Denmark. And even this boy, before to a life in Nervalela Kayana, the Real Machek.
The Real Machek,
remember
yeah,
the boy yeah. was good in Nele and Kago Stellenbosch. So,
very good.
Oh, no, Mulusi is the deep boy. Just that Coach Steve Parker is a good coach.
And he brought Mudaga recently. And Mudaga is
even
one of
brought
the best.
Mudaga, the best left back.
Exactly.
And remember, the boy was from Chief DDC.
Oh, yes.
Hey, the boy was playing for Chief DDC.
Yeah. So, and he scored in their first in his first game.
Yeah, I remember they were playing, games.
Yeah, they were playing in Mozambique. He scored there.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see Jorge, like he's doing good. And look, for instance, I think it's first time they play in the CAF Confederation Cup.
For the first time.
And he won 8-0.
Well, they're playing the CAF Confederation. They won 8-0 aggregate. So I believe Coach Steve Parker Mofema Bloma enough. And,
yeah.
I was telling someone, refill coach, Pizzo, doctor.
Yeah.
We have coached, we have Dr. Pizzo Musimane.
Yeah.
I was telling someone, I believe the guy who deserves this thing is Steve Parker.
Yeah. Ne?
I think the guy has been mocking me for a long time.
Yeah.
Remember, Stellenbosch, I know he promoted. I know if you want my bad is not easy.
Exactly.
Mara,
exactly.
I believe the guy's been loyal to our game and contributed a lot to South African football. So I believe Sanchi at least, I don't recognize the guy, to be honest. Recognize the guy. The guy who deserves a lot of things from us South Africans.
And even now, last season he was. He won the Carling Black Label Cup.
He won the Carling Black Label
first cup of the team, and this season he's on the verge to win the MTN 8 for the first time.
We lost to semi-final last season against Mamelodi Sundowns.
Exactly.
So this season, one game left.
And it was a clutch game, man. Mamelodi Sundowns beat them recently twice.
Yeah, twice. Home and away.
Home and away. So you can see that, you know, that coach is one
very
of the
good.
Best.
Very good. Yeah.
And is gonna give Orlando Pirates tough time.
Yes.
We are not sure yet where is the final going to, but then wherever where he's going, because Leander, that coach, he's under pressure. Remember, Coach Benny McCarthy won it with Cape Town City.
Won it with Cape Town City.
Exactly. Yeah. Even Barker will want to win
with Stellenbosch.
With Stellenbosch.
Yeah.
You understand? Yeah.
It's going to be a great game, the cup game. So. Both teams do on form. Orlando Pirates is on form.
Yeah.
Stellenbosch is on form. So we'll just see. Mara, normally, the other day we were talking about the football gods.
Yeah.
Remember,
yeah.
I was telling you about the football gods, or when it comes to CAF Champions League, they favor Al Ahly. When it comes to
Real Madrid,
that one,
they
favor Real Madrid. So truth need to be told, or. The football gods, when it comes to MTN 8, they favor Orlando Pirates.
Orlando
Pirates. Wish Stellenbosch can win it, but the way Orlando Pirates are
dangerous. But I'm happy that, you know, they are both going to the finals so that we can see, because we've been seeing Mamelodi Sundowns and Pirates in the finals for the past 2 years. And then now it's a new one now.
And
it's two of the best coaches that we have.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, last season Barker was also nominated, ne?
As yeah,
the coach
he was
of the season.
Yeah.
Amongst the two,
Rulani Mokoena
and Jose. So this season now they are both going to the finals. It's going to be an interesting one.
Yeah.
Let's just thank our guest, our viewers. Thank you very much for joining us. Thank you very much for making sure that you keep on supporting us. Jimmy Mutoka Tobela, let me read some of your comments. Jimmy Mutoka says, Tobela Jimmy Mutoka for the love of the game. Away must again. Thank you very much for the support. Please make sure that you also go to our YouTube channel. We are not yet live on YouTube channel, but then you can go to our YouTube channel and subscribe to our 2010 Sharp Eye channel. Also follow us on Twitter, same name, Ngobo 2010. We are also on Instagram at Ngobo 2010. Also follow this page and make sure that, you know, you support us. If you want to give us some gifts there with the stars and everything, please do that. We'll appreciate that. As you can see, we don't have a studio yet, so
yeah.
We still need to buy microphones and, you know, to buy the mixers and everything, so that, you know, we can keep on updating you with everything. Thank you very much for liking the videos and loving them, you know, tapping that screen. We really appreciate you. I saw a comment here by let's see, like Luki Maloko. I agree with you, Iniesta. I also think Coach Nabi will do well in the Carling Black Label, and that will give them their confidence back. It's true.
Yeah, it's true.
And I was just thinking when you said, when you spoke about the league.
The league, yeah.
Yeah, the league is a big one.
It's a big one.
Yeah, it's a big one. And also, you know, we are out.
All eyes already on Orlando Pirates or Kewa Knight, Hissing Cup, Breaker, Record Yamaha, Melody Sundowns.
Yeah, but then we can't, like, shut them down.
Yeah, yeah. They can surprise us.
They can surprise us also, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And they didn't qualify for MTN 8.
Yeah,
so that
yeah.
one we can't count.
Yeah, it's only three trophies.
Only three trophies left.
League, NetBank, and MTN.
And MTN.
League
and Carling Black Label. So
yeah.
Hopefully they will come and surprise us and make sure that they win.
Yeah.
But then yeah, thank you very much for supporting the channel. Make sure that, you know, you keep on supporting the channel. We are here for you. We are going to interact with you. If you want to join us, you can join us anytime, and then we are going to make sure that, you know, we give you everything that you want, soccer wise, ne?
Yes.
I'd like us to, you know, continue. Is there any maybe other coaches that you would like us to touch that we didn't touch?
Yeah, I think Coach Kwanele Kop from Shipa United is one coach you look elevated, na. I think the guy will surprise many. So the guy, I know him from Pretoria Kellys.
Uh-huh.
The guy, he was doing good there. He was doing good. Just that he was under chairman, that chairman Malaudzi, yeah, from Pretoria Kellys.
Yeah.
And then remember, they signed him as a co-coach with Tabo September. Go Chiba United.
Yeah.
Now
yeah.
he's the head coach.
Yeah.
So I believe
is September still there?
Yeah, September is assistant coach.
Oh,
yes,
beautiful,
yes.
Beautiful.
So I believe the guy is going to show us a good football.
Mm-hmm.
And also, I still repeat, or coach Putimuhaf, the guy. Yeah, he's my homeboy. He's from Malaysia.
Yeah.
I like the guy. So, and he was one of the best defenders. So Coach Putimuhaf, remember, Orbon Chijak is Mamelodi Sundowns, or he can play a good football.
He was just maybe, you know, let down by that.
On goal line, it's part of the game.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I believe Coach Putimuhaf, Coach Kwanele Kop, obviously we can write off Coach Gavin Hunt, is going to do good also.
Yeah.
Remember, Osa and good players, Lena. The other one, we'll see Manova, Mr. Manova. So
that one I want us to plug in for now.
Yeah.
Also, one of the coaches that, you know, I like, it's Coach Denden's Malesela.
Denden Malesela.
One of the best coaches that we have ever had in South Africa, who's underrated, you know. Few years ago, I thought just before they announced Coach,
Okay.
At Kaizer Chiefs, I thought they're gonna bring him back. Because of then he's good, you know, with carpet football.
Yeah.
Look what he did with Chiba United.
Chess Galaxy.
You know, Baroka.
He won that bang with Chess Galaxy.
Exactly.
Beating Kaizer Chiefs
in the finals.
Yeah.
You can see that, you know, that coach is very good. What is happening at Chiba right now? And what is happening at Baroka, like the style of play, even
because of
Denden, because of him,
even Marumo Gallant, the guy
also.
Was the problem I have with Coach Denden.
Yeah,
I like the guy. Give me an opportunity or give you lele. Now at the time he was coach at Marumo Gallant, so give me a chance in Chovale. He's closely on a player. This one, they are my players, and wherever I go now. But some my little one, the likes of Kolamulambo, Joseph Mulongwane, on a player.
The
only problem, then, that's why we're not changing the team.
Mm.
When the chairman, team with this or jump, with this or how high. So, like, Udumela, everything, then. So, that's why we're not going to do that.
But as I said earlier on that, you know, sometimes our coaches, especially South African coaches, it's about pap and place. You want to put bread on the table.
Yeah.
And sometimes you are fired today, tomorrow, you don't have anything, you have got kids, they must go to school and all that. Mm. Where they take you, you want to go there. Just imagine he was in a road to
PSL, go to playoffs.
PSL in the playoffs. Yeah. He played one game and then he was fired.
Mm.
You understand? Mm-hmm. And Baroka lost, you know, at the end of the day. But then in terms of like being a yo-yo or maybe a teabag and all that, it's something that, you know, coaches won't control that because it's like anywhere, even yourself. Like, let's say, understand, someone hires you, they fire you, and then you get another job. Understand? One. And they bring you back.
Kinto ilor nevle like coach Dylan K after was no mukova go. I believe he resigned before everything in Adria because. Agree for Tabadi coach.
Oh, yeah.
So, into Lauri, most of black coaches, they don't know what they stand for. So, into Lauri, most of the European coaches, what's the one to Benyaga? I mind or Baka resign anytime. And before Rikaya Hul, I know it's not part of the script. Sorry,
no problem, yeah.
Reminder, Kamotoko, Arbutaka, Ronwen Williams, Ka, Nominia Haya, Yushin. Nominee.
Oh, remember, yes.
Goalkeeper of the season for Ballon d'Or.
Yeah,
the guy is nominated. He's in top 10. So Ubitile Wo Onana from Manchester United. So he's the only African goalkeeper there. I believe Kitaba Yela, African Cup of Nations.
Yes,
those penalties and everything. Thanks, Motoko, for reminding us.
Thank you very much, Kimi. And also on that note, I remember a few years ago we had also our player. Masuluke.
Oscar Masuluke
who scored that, you know,
from Baroque against Pirates at Peter Mugawa Stadium.
In South Africa, he couldn't win
goal of the season. They gave it to Spiro Tshabalala.
You know, when it comes to Chiefs, Chiefs fans,
get a vote.
When you vote against Chiefs fans, obviously, you never win. You understand?
Never got Gulo, Loka Koraka, Yakatepini, and then Kashapa Cracker.
Yeah.
Mar, and obviously, ke for Meteloria Verega Misango. So, we can't blame the league or if he lay a Chiefs player.
My brother, if they put it there, they say, fans, they must vote. I'm telling you, even if they can say now, we are voting for Kevin Johnson as a coach of the season,
you're
going to win.
Exactly.
Because Chiefs fans, they don't
want to
lose.
Last season, player, the Chiefs said we need goal of the month. Got goal, didn't we?
Exactly. like you can't. But yeah, but then on that note, Oscar and Masuluke went there also.
It's Puskas.
Yeah, Puskas, yeah.
It was not for goalkeeper. Goalkeeper went for the Puskas.
Exactly.
He finished top three.
Yes. And you can see that. That goal, if we supported him,
he was gonna win
as a not only as a country as a but continent. As a continent,
yeah,
he was gonna win that one because even Lionel Messi said he's gonna win it.
Even Cristiano Ronaldo said he's gonna win it. The goalkeeper from Africa,
exactly. And unfortunately, some of us we voted, but it was not enough.
We don't support our own,
exactly. Now it's Ronan Williams. Let's hope that, you know, we're going to push him and for him to go. We know sometimes it might not be enough, but let's just push. At least he can.
Mara, at least top somewhere. Five, at least even top three, because the guy did well compared to other goalkeepers. Because if you can check, it's only Martinez from Argentina.
Yeah.
I believe the guy can a lot. Yes, he deserved the trophy because he won Copa, he won World Cup, he won everything.
That's
Ronwen Williams. Compared to other goalkeepers, Yuen Soma, I believe he's also going to be in top three. So,
hopefully, maybe it's going to be only those three. But hopefully, South Africans and Africans as a whole will vote for him and make sure that, you know, he at least he can be in the top three, and then so that he can go and represent us. That side. But yeah, going forward, I think we are done with the coaches. But then. What I like, you know, South Africans to do in terms of the coaches, we need to respect the South African coaches.
Yes.
Give them their flowers. Make sure that, you know, we give them an opportunity. I know that lately the chairman, they need coaches to grind results and all that.
Hence,
you see other coaches are not giving the youngsters the chances. They think, or like, if I can give Mfundo or I can give Mabena a chance, if he makes a mistake, it's on me, understand? Mm, so let's hope that, you know, all those coaches, they can learn on like learn from Jose Rivero.
We even forget what happened to Coach Busimusi Vilagasi at Richards Bay.
Yeah, exactly.
The guy saved status of the team. Right. And then, Mara, sometimes it's about this chairman and the sponsors.
I was surprised that, you know, it was the sponsor that took that decision.
Yeah, it was the sponsor. Yeah.
To Power FM.
Yeah.
It was Maskepe Matsiban who was
on Power.
On Power. Yeah, it was Maskepe.
Even Andile Ngcube on Sportsnet Amplified even fought with the guy.
Is it?
Yeah, they were fighting on air about that issue. Or
exactly.
You said the guy drove a coach and then then lately the sponsor won about their decision.
Because I had the clip, my brother, the following day, like a day before they announced the sponsorship and the new jerseys and few players, and then on the clip he said clip, I think it's what sponsor is it,
Zagwe guess.
He said, we have a coach right now, but we want an experienced coach.
Yes.
And I was like, is this a sponsor or an owner? But then we don't know.
Maybe, yeah.
Because Tina is supporters, we don't know what's happening behind the scenes and all that. We don't know.
And they give the team $100 million.
Yeah, 100 million.
Yeah, for 3 years.
Yeah, for 3 years.
Yeah.
It is divided into three. I think the 30 million for facility, 30 million for maybe
community,
and also 40 million for they wanted to also buy maybe more players and all that. But yeah, I hope it's gonna help them. But hopefully, as I say, what, like, guys, we have got young coaches out there. We have got Abo Tugutug Makanya.
Yeah, he's doing well.
At Pirates, you know. We have got, like, now we have double Fabian McCarthy, who just got their coaching licenses. All of them. Hopefully, you know, they'll come up and be respected. You understand?
Yeah,
and also our players, they need to respect these coaches.
Yes.
Yeah. You wanted to touch on Mangoba.
Yeah, and yeah. Because Mangoba. Because Mangoba.
Let's wrap it up with him.
Yeah, yeah.
I like the coach.
Yeah.
He's a good coach. He's a
I also
coach.
Like him. Yeah,
he's a very, very good coach. He's a respected coach. Mm. Unfortunately, you know, he's coaching a big team, because it's first time that he's coaching the big team. Because he has been coaching Golden Arrows for a very long time, and back then, and then he came to Sundowns. There was Pito. Then Rulani,
Lade.
You understand? Then Steve. Mm, so we couldn't judge him.
Now
it's on him.
It's on him.
And the supporters are on him.
Yeah.
And, some of the media are also on him. But then, according to you, he has played 3 games now.
Yeah.
He hasn't scored a goal.
Yeah.
Well, that was an goal.
Yeah.
But then, Do you think he's gonna turn things around?
Yeah.
After losing the 2 games against Stellenbosch, and now he's going to Mbabane. He's going to play with Swallows in the CAF Champions League. Then
and Solidarity,
Super Sport United. But, like, what do you think about his situation as a coach?
The last 3 games he played, Coach Mangoba. There are a lot of positives still, or you can take from that game. So I believe Mamelodi Sundowns played well, but the way Coach Awuleje Kaona, from the first day, Abiyua Coach Ore, Mamelodi Sundowns, this season we're going to see a lot of goals outside from the box.
Yeah.
So since Mamelodi Sundowns hit home, all those things still Coach Mangoba are relating. They never happened since hit home. Lot of players, I think, Digi isolating since on the field, especially the likes of Allende, because we expected a lot from these players.
Yeah.
And I believe if Coach Mangoba and Gepe are continuing whatever a lot of work from Coach Rulani, they almost panel. I believe Sali Elorekaja Jamar, from what I've seen from the past 3 games, I believe Coach Mangoba so far is going to struggle if he continue that style of play. Yes, I said, or There are a lot of positive jello regarding from style of play, Sir Coach Man. But there are a lot of chances being created. Kope loko, Mara. There are but many chances those guys,
hey,
and even the players Valor Otraya overlooking the system, it's gonna be tough. Cause lately, Rubona the likes of Letlagu and Kepler Lor overlooking or not this season. Rubona yeah, Letlagu exactly, is going to play, and lately, no, the guy who's going to play some. The big man Shalulile, this guy from Brazil, sales. Yeah. So it's not gonna be. It's even this thing. You change the position. Can tell or negi bale la or we know the Enkaya Mamelodi Sundowns normally. It's like it's a war.
Yeah.
Or. Rivaldo Kotzi.
Yes.
So
yes, yes, yes.
So lately you can see your. More Alende is more of that rule, they like and everything, which is wrong. It won't work for Mamelodi Sundowns.
Yeah,
and I go with this thing, go with recycling position.
Yeah.
The guy must recycle, so you can do that. Kinto Lor Sanchi Drake with the Womkwena and others. And Ohonavana style of play, Sakwit Mangova, Ofukasi Jamudu in back, so Dimdirele Mereko.
Yeah,
and which he looks something a little Ekasimus panel because. This modern football, we need wingers. It's a lot of the last part. So, focus a high, a more the fullbacks, which is the fullbacks are high. Yes, there are some football fullbacks, Taylor. They know what allowed that system. If you can check what Trent Arnold, Bo Walker from Man City,
yeah.
Those guys, they know what they are doing. So, Oka Cheka Mashiro from Mamelodi Sundowns and Mudiba. Manuel ka flow ya
game. Yeah, it's a problem because the way as we were saying earlier on, for like the way they are playing, it's like there's traffic. Even if you can check on the right, Mudau, sometimes they'll play Mudau and Murray at the same time.
And sometimes they even play Libusa.
And he would run forward and then maybe a senior baller,
one of them
covering him, yeah.
And Okara was checking from the middle field. Those guys, Agbatwe Lor, Babanga, Honumak, Sabale Laka, Allen. And that thing frustrated Plara Jotana, Jotana, Wumguena, and a little like a Jim Chelor, Mamelodi Sundowns, Nesakur. And at Wumguena, we all know, Kaplare Lor, or adult their responsibility,
yeah.
Abatamel, our shooter. So,
exactly, yeah.
Whenever I take it, Eva Matata for Mamelodi Sundowns, Mudivo overlepile. Mashiro overlepile, Mukwena again at Serembolo. All those places, the players, Tamamelodi Sundowns, different legal boxing.
Yeah.
So once they lose the ball, obviously they
counter-attack.
Team did like Mamelodi Sundowns.
Teams like Bo Stellenbosch.
Stellenbosch.
They capitalize on those things. Yeah.
They know where to punish.
Look at Mujela.
Mujela was the team auto punish. And they have good players, Taylor. Once you lose a ball, but the way pass. So Mamelodi Sundowns, I think they must fix their final third. So far, you have a beta. But it's only three games. I know Masandawana Vanyuko wana the results. And obviously, those signings were the last season. Respect our MTN 8. It was a must for Wana Sanchevaiti.
Exactly.
But Bapale. So it's going to be tough
for Wana.
Yeah. So anyway, so they were struggling at MTN 8. So for now, Mangoba so far, if you continue that thing, he's going to struggle.
Yeah, but now on my side, you know, the team has been doing well. They've been creating chances.
Yeah,
there are other, you know, instances where the ball will hit the post, and also the goalkeeper will be the man of the match and all that. The only problem that I've seen is that, you know, when the new coaches comes in, they want to change the previous coach's philosophy.
Every time, Mamelodi Sundowns.
Because I was so surprised when Sundowns played Kulukwane City, he substituted Mudau. And I'm like, why do you substitute Mudau is one of the
You bench Tembazwane.
And Tembazwane is an experienced player, yes. But then you bench him and then you want to play him in the second game.
He's not a super sub.
He's done.
He's done. Mudau 65 or 70 minutes.
Exactly. Look now, he's at Bafana Bafana.
He's a captain.
He's going
now.
To be captain on Friday. He's going to start.
That thing will motivate him.
Mm.
Understand? And we'll see. 80 minutes, Hugo Bruce will take him out.
And other thing, Krutman, the thing here, Coach Jamal Mamelodi Sundowns, especially Coach Mangova, remember then he introduced the late Truma Chavala, like 68, the Shushan Piano from Brazil.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So yeah. If you can check, I believe this thing, if a legend, Paul Deleza, the late Dimitri,
yeah,
and John Neskins, Urla Ficha Azama, we did, and Pizzo Lena, I social science thing going on.
Yeah.
So Rulane, he was playing more of it, Shushan and Piano, Narebona.
Exactly.
Maranoman over, no. What's a measure that thing, no. Because Shushan Piano, I tell you,
it's a history
of Mamelodi Sundowns, yeah, like culture.
Even culture. Back then, I remember Bo Zola Mohobe.
Kazola, during the Chitlas Zola Mohobe.
Exactly, understand. He was one of the people which he wanted, you know, them to play that Shushan
Piano.
You understand? If you can check also, we're talking about then Smadisela later. If he can come to Chief to Sundowns,
he's gonna stick to that.
He's gonna stick to that.
And it's gonna matter again. It's gonna matter. That's why I get it. No, but Chavela, that thing, Shushan Piano, and the culture of Mamelodi Sundowns.
It's a culture. It's what is beating now the young boy Maseko.
I just
hope that, you know, they can teach him the style Sundowns.
Check a lodge. The game jadi dalle underruler. Exactly. Because first game or Mokito need that was almost so. I did not so on. Remember, Lodge, who really did give ya a little Sundowns and was still, but you're benching Otsaumo break. I know he's injured now. Mara, whatever he drank for Sundowns is very painful. Yeah, it's, I know Masandawa and Atalale Renare, but it's still early. No, but you can't run away from Shushan and
but one thing I can tell you, Nyastane, we are here, we are also supporters. And like here at number 2010 Sharp Eye, we are just neutral.
Yeah.
Whatever that we want to say, you can say the way it is. We're not gonna be scared to tell it the way it is. Chiefs supporters, Pirates, Sundowns, whatever. remember when you say something, say Lohore, it's the truth. Some people they don't like it.
Yeah.
So we are going to criticize. But constructively,
yeah.
Even yourselves there at home, make sure that, you know, when you hear something wrong, it's fine. You can criticize us. You can, you know, build us.
Feel free.
Just feel free. We're going to talk about Sundowns, Pirates, Chiefs, whoever that is. You know, if we would abadlali kahle, sizokhuluma ngabo ukuthi abadlali kahle. Maybe dlala kahle, sizobanqoma futhi. But for now, let's just read the comments.
Yeah.
I can see there's a lot of comments here. I saw Plantina Sehaye, one of the Mamelodi Sundowns supporters. He's congratulating Ronan Williams.
Yeah.
For the nomination. Thank you very much, Plantina, for joining
Plantina.
Us. Serati Mary, they sent us the stars. Thank you very much for the stars.
Serati.
Thank you very much for giving us the stars here. Letabo Nwanyani is having a positive comment. Kawena, my brother. this young boy this young man is a football. Is a what? This young man is a football star.
Thanks, Letabo. Thanks.
Please send those stars. Don't forget to send those stars. And give us the gifts, and then we'll appreciate them. And thank you for the comments. We'll keep on reading them. Make sure that, you know, we give you what you want. Thank you, Luki Muloko, for the stars. We really appreciate it. We really appreciate them. There's another comment that I've seen here. Nomvula Mapula, Iniesta
08.
Iniesta 08, watching all the way from Rode Port, San Juan de thank you very much for joining us. There's also here, okay, Jimmy Mutokwa. Jimmy Mutokwa, available is our number one fan.
Yeah.
he's saying, well done, gents, keep it up. Ricky Shea, very informative, gents, keep it up. Thank you very much. You know, that's a positive comment also there. Sakile, Mr. Cow, Sakile Nkomo. Bafo, I'm still waiting for you, Jan. I'm still waiting for you. He's saying what? Okay, let me just sondeza this next to me. What worked for Rulani was him taking over from Pito and not changing everything. He worked on what Pito left while he was working on installing. While he was working on installing. Where is it? Okay, let me start off. Sorry. What worked for Rulani was him taking over from Pito and not changing everything. He worked on what Pito left while he was working on installing bit by bit what wanted to be he wanted to build, and he worked and it worked for him. With Coach Manqoba, he is trying to change everything, and that gives red flags that they were not working good with Manqoba. Anyway, with Sundowns' way of play, now that I don't like it, is Alende playing too, so deep, which I find him, this is what we were saying about Alende. He say, Mr. Kao is saying that what he doesn't like about Alende is that he's playing so deep, and I find him more effective through half spaces, so he can supply more. Another one is this is what he doesn't like about what his son is doing.
When it's true.
Yeah, another one is keeping Mushishi out of.
You want to say out of position.
Oh, out of position, yeah.
Yeah.
Come on, like for real. Can him out. Is there something you want to build?
Aish.
Understand? Thank you very much.
Thanks.
We really appreciate your comments. These are positive comments. What we have said about Alende and also about Mushishi, it's something that Coach Manqoba is trying to change, but we don't know what is that. Why is he doing that and all that? But maybe in the long run it was going to work for him. Maybe
because it's still 3 games.
Exactly.
Now.
Yeah. But thank you very much for the comments. Novula Mapula is saying, just don't criticize Chiefs too much, because with that, the fans won't be happy. No, but then we have to criticize Chiefs. Remember,
yeah,
last season, Kaiser Chiefs couldn't qualify for top 8.
Yeah,
I understand.
Which is bad for the brand.
Which is bad for the brand, which is also bad for South Africa.
Yeah, yeah.
And all the criticism that came to Chiefs, Mapula, Nomvula, it's they are the ones that made the technical team to sign the new players.
Because they can react to Chiefs.
They wouldn't.
Exactly. So never needed that thing or maybe out of top 8.
Exactly.
Chiefs they can sign Jablo Blom and they can sign Serena and others.
Exactly.
So it was good for Chiefs even out of top 8. Even the 16 coaches, most of them, they are saying if Chiefs is high perform, it's bad for the brand, it's bad for economy.
I remember even the chairman at TS Galaxy, Tim Sugazi.
Yeah, yeah.
Also the
even Mr. Cobbins, Cape Town City. Yeah.
They are saying the same thing. And if you can check, like when Chiefs is in the competition. Unfortunately, they're not in the top 8 now. But when they're in a competition, it brings economy to that particular city where they are going to play.
Remember, ticket gig is 60 rand for 40 rand. But when you play Chiefs, cup competition, but it's a ticket for 40 rand.
And it exactly.
Hey, yeah.
And it becomes sold out.
And we're more town on the Chiefs if it's Lord. So something a lot we can't run away from.
Exactly.
Like Chiefs is a big brand.
Yeah.
Not saying the likes of Mamelodi Sundowns is not a big brand.
Yeah.
Guys, to be honest, Kaiser Chiefs is a big brand.
It's the thing is, some people they don't want to agree to that, saying Uchi, we can't say Chiefs is a big brand because they are not winning things. But all in all, Chiefs is a big brand.
Mamelodi Sundowns and Orlando Pirates are currently the best teams. Kaiser Chiefs is a big brand.
Exactly.
Get the way.
That's how it is. It won't change.
Yeah.
Only thing that Chiefs must do now is to win 5 games in a row.
Yeah.
You will see.
ukuthi amakhosi athanda.
Ah, libile 5 is too much. 3 games.
3 games is fine.
Chiefs in 3 games in a row.
Chiefs win one game, they won Real Madrid.
They won Man City Real Madrid. Trophy.
Yeah.
So I believe we can go to the players.
Yeah. Okay. I saw some of the comments here. Thank you very much, Ajao. Welcome, Shongwe. Sbali Wami. Kwena Sbali.
Thank you,
Sbali.
Thank you, Sbali. Thank you, Mlamo.
Thank you, Mlamo Wami. Zamake. In the cool, but great analysis, guys. Thank you very much, Sebo. Cool. Thank you very much. Zamake is the one who assisted us with the footage yesterday.
Okay.
So thank you very much. And
thank you
for the support. You know, we are having the lights today because of you. Thank you very much. We really appreciate it. Yeah, we can. I think we've already touched, you know, on a lot of things. What was fun yesterday about Coach Nabi, he said he's here to cause problem for the 15 coaches.
Yeah.
And I saw the coaches were laughing at him. So you know, such comments.
And it's a good thing for me. They know headlines every day.
Exactly.
Yeah.
For those who haven't seen that, we have it on our website, www.ngobo2010sharpi.com. There we are covering everything sports, everything PSL, also Bafana Bafana and CAF Champions League. So please support the channel. Make sure that you the website, make sure that you just go there and read whatever that they we're going to involve you also, the fans. There's a Colombia defense Mola where I would, you know, it's a new thing that we have started. Mm-hmm. And I think Uti Izo Caesar, Nabanya Bantu, Abalandeli, and all that, you know, we are going to profile them also. People like Mutokwa is one of the fans that I've interviewed.
Okay.
And I've also put him there. On you can check on the menu there. There's where it says support us. Just click on support us. Ngobo2010sharpi.com. You'll read what Mutokwa. You read his interview there. So thank you very much. Let's go forward, my brother. I think we can talk about maybe the new signings for this season. And I've seen a lot of signings.
There are a lot of signings.
And I just hope that they are going to bring, you know, they are going to bring, you know, positivity, because, you know, most of the time you find that you sign a player.
It's just there to add number.
And they're just there to, you understand. So, but hopefully, you know, they're gonna, you know, bring, you know, changes and all that. Let's start with AmaZulu, né?
Yeah.
AmaZulu has signed Senzon Dlovu from Sinenkani FC. They've signed Boniface Haba, Olympic Safi, Luvuyo Pewa from Mamelodi Sundowns. They've also signed Ikadoro from Mamelodi Sundowns. They signed Fison Ngobeni, Mamelodi Sundowns. I remember Ngobeni is the one who played for
left back Celtics. Yeah.
They also signed
Kwandam
Gonyama from Mamelodi Moroka Swallows. I remember Kwandam Gonyama, you know, played a very, very good role, when he was at just before Swallows, Maritzburg United.
They
also Andy Sastole from Devon City, formerly known as
Maritzburg
United. In those supporters, in those players that I've mentioned there, which one do you think, you know, is a good signing for AmaZulu?
I think Sifiso Ngobeni, obviously, on the left back side.
And he didn't get a chance for
Chance for Sundowns. He's a good player, obviously. Otro Eda experience high go AmaZulu. And obviously the big man, the striker, Ikadaro. Chipa United. So Piwa, former Mamelodi Sundowns player. I remember him from Amatrax. I believe ke player lore e ka change dilo kwa
mazu. Exactly. I think you know, with Abo Ngobeni and all other players, Abo Ikador, those players, they were not given a chance
in the biggest
teams. And they had a lot of competition anyway at Sundowns. You know, Sundowns, you know, is a big team.
Yeah, Sundowns is a big team.
Yeah, but then let's go forward, you know, to Cape Town City. I saw, you know, Makaringe, you know, he was playing, former Orlando Pirates player. He was playing against his former team.
And he played well, home and away.
Yeah, but let me just give you all of them, the ones that they signed. Carlos Docamo, also known as Kalinos, from Petro de Luanda. Petro de Luanda game.
We have almost five players from Petro de Luanda.
From Petro, yeah. We're going to mention them as time goes on. Lefa Apane from Zanin United. Elson Ayanda Stole from Magesi. Fortune Makaringe from Orlando Pirates. Kaden Francis from Chippa United. Hasim Domingos from AS FAR Rabat.
Yeah.
Hashim Domingo, is it the one from Sundowns?
They sent him. He was playing AS FAR Rabat. Yeah, he was there. He played there one season.
Oh, yeah.
Under coach Joseph Simba.
I remember, yeah. We have got the experienced Kamohelo Mkojo from United. Amadou Skouna from Bangkok United. Ntsikelelo Nonga from Morosalus.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you comment on that?
Obviously, without a doubt, Kamuelo Mkojo, one of the biggest signing.
Yeah.
Fortune Makaringe, obviously, you know, he played well home and away.
Yeah.
Guy MTN8. And also, obviously, Hashim Domingo, jersey number 10, without a doubt.
Yeah.
And this young boy, he was at Zanin United. Mm-hmm. I think he Lefa Apane, very good player. At his Zanin United. Lefa Apane. I saw him guardy play off ja ABC Mutsepeliki or Teflop. That's where Coach Tingler signed him on.
Very good player.
So I believe, yeah.
Because I remember Tingler, they were playing their off season in
Never let go limp over the range. Really chance or when they play off ja.
Because you know the weather in Cape Town was very bad. Remember even Coach here, Chess Galaxy complained about that pitch. Exactly, they lost against Stellenbosch. The
MTN first game.
Knockout. So, even last week when Pirates was supposed to play on Tuesday and then the game was postponed.
Mm.
But hopefully, you know, those boys who are gonna make changes there at Cape Town City, Chippa United. We have got Giovanni Flender from Stenberg United. Andile Jali, the experienced.
He
signed as a free agent previously for Mazibugo. Also, you know, from Jomo Cosmos. Samukelo Jali from Maritzburg United. Olani. Sithole from Pretoria Kellys. Tawane Jacobs from Pretoria Kellys also. Apel Teto from Livingston. Azola Matrose from Orlando Pirates. Boy Madimwane from Baroka FC, Malibuko Mudise from Mamelodi Sundowns. Yeah.
AJ15, without a doubt.
I see the experience as Andy Leja.
Yeah, AJ15. Yeah. I believe it will add a number more. He's going to go Chippa United. Mm-hmm. Obviously, Azola Matros. Nil Plaraya Chippa United, Chippa, yeah. I believe Lena Otojala. And there's this young boy from Baroka, Boy Madingwane. They're still fighting for him ko Baroka or without their permission.
Yeah,
so
because I had the chairman,
Khurushimpatlele,
he mentioned him that, you know, they still want him back, he's still their player and all that. But as long as they have signed him,
obviously the big signing is Andy Legend.
That's the big one, yeah. Okay, we let's go to Golden Arrows, number 10. Keegan Phillips from Moroka Swallows, Bongani Tele from JDR, Luanda Mbandra from Moroka Swallows, Menzi Masuku from Royal AM, Edward Maova from University of Pretoria, Blessing Nkunu from TS Galaxy, Ishmael Watenga from Mamelodi Sundowns, Keenan Phillips from Moroka Swallows, and Mwedi Vandala from Venda FC.
I think they made mistake. He played. He was at Magaze. He was with Magaze last season. So they released him.
He wasn't loaned.
No, they released him. He was on the list. They released him.
Oh, okay.
So kengangisana the computer. So I know he's our boy. We released him. He's at Golden Arrows. I believe Ishmael Watanga, the goalkeeper, is gonna do well. Go Arrows. Obviously the centre back Keenan Phillips.
Even forgetting
Menzi Masuk
also, was he called Royal AM?
Yeah, he was at Royal Andile Bisana Football Club.
Exactly. All right, let's go to Amakhosi for life. I'm a fan of Twitter. Oh,
the Pefenik Lemma Boys.
I'm a fan of Capello Moya. Right, they have Bongani Sam from Pirates. Franklin Tuari from TS Galaxy, Roshan Dockley from Cape Town Spurs. They've got Gaston Serrino from Mamelodi Sundowns. Ignacio Miguel from Petro di Luanda. They've got also, yesterday they've signed Jablo Blom.
And also Cross
from Golden Arrows.
For me,
big names there.
For me, the big one, I know I see Serino, but the big one is on the edge, Njabulo Blom. The guy is the core. Best sign is so far for Kaiser Chiefs. I know again, I thought Dala Sharp, and obviously, Serino, I believe. So, the guy Miguel, I got some rate for now because we have that mentality or. So I believe the plus to Dala, obviously Blom, Serene, obviously, and the young Russian Dodley, I believe Lena Katlala.
And you know what will give him also confidence is that he has been selected national team by Go Bruce.
And remember, he was the captain during Kosovo Cup.
Kosovo Cup, exactly. What happened with the Velebai?
Oh, the issue available, the diamond guy. Obviously, Chiefs, Irlekasi Patel, that man. And obviously, relationship we have on Alice Pesa, I don't think guy Kaspan, of course.
Exactly,
remember, no lordly were through media and everything. I don't think it's going to work.
But let's touch on that before we continue with the new signings. I saw him playing against Amatax.
I was also there.
Body language.
The boy is very good. The boy is talented. But the way they are fighting for him and everything, the boy reminds me of George Lewis. But he's more quicker.
Exactly.
Mara, I don't think someone Olori is going to make miracles. Coaches, how to change a situation in 2 minutes. I don't think someone Olori come like the way and the price money by Ivan Koy.
Too much.
Because the boy played 100 games for Spurs. Yes, maybe 5 assists, one goal, one Bafana cap.
Imagine,
So,
agree like the
12 million for that player. I know it's diamond, but not 12 million.
The problem is the chairman said they groomed him, and unfortunately, the teams also they demoralize these boys. I've seen with big teams whereby, if you can check, for instance, I'll mention the likes of Tiko Modise, Botemi Kosi Lodge. Those players, their game dropped. You understand? Towards the end because of they were promised to go overseas. Even Saleng also dropped last season. I think Saleng was because of he couldn't win the football of the season. Also, Mabasa, also they wanted him overseas. You could see his game, it dropped a little bit. But then, in terms of, the chairman, denying these boys to go overseas, to go explore themselves, do you think that plays a very, very a big role in terms of demoralizing those players?
Yeah, true, because... this boy is the dream store of the Europe and big teams. No one is going to turn off your kids at Chiefs.
Exactly.
Remember, Roshan Dodley once Chiefs in Munyaka, before Libya was signed and the airport. So remember the story of Pesita. We learned the same thing. Mamelodi Sundowns. So even Pesita's parents came to go to Lord Kopo. the chairman, the president, Dr. Patrice Motsepe. So, Mara, at the end of the day, Ntongo, Mr. Ngobo Santere, understand the core. These people, they are also running a business.
Yeah.
They invest in these boys. Like, Odala Academy, Baudrela, everything. Bausha Skolo, Baudrela, everything.
Exactly, yeah.
So, this situation, like, I'm going to blow. So, Nermakala, Abdala first team, Mara, Ogra Salavia 20,000.
Imagine.
And the best player with Chiefs.
Ish.
So Chiefs and you three taka academy player for the rest of your life.
Yeah, you know.
So you'll be academy player for the rest of your life.
Yeah, actually that's how they do. When they groomed you, they'll give you that salary of the academy.
Yeah, yeah.
Look at, for instance, players like Abo Junior Kanye,
Boscat
Malats and other players.
They
couldn't get the salaries that they because sometimes
they come from the academy.
Because when you come from the Chiefs academy, they'll say no, we have groomed you, this is the money that we want to give you, and then you must sign here. And then when you are excited, you say, I'm going to play for Chiefs,
even the parents will sign.
Sometimes they'll give you 5 years. This is what happened with also Steve Nkulia at Pirates. I think he was giving, if I'm not mistaken, 5 or 10 years, I'm not sure, but I stand to be corrected.
Even his boy,
but I remember Steve Nkulia was given that a long term contract in Gemale Ngana. Remember, he even started when he scored a goal, he started celebrating.
Hey,
So you can see, Uchi, you know, some of the players they signed this contract in the excitement, and then also saying, you know, I'm going to Chiefs, I'm going to Pirates. And then only to find Uchi, after a year or two, you've performed very well, more than someone who just came in. Now, imagine a player comes in, holler 100,000, when holler 50,000, and you are the best performer. And also, you are the one who's dishing the goals for him.
For example, on paper, he's supposed to be one of the highest paid player go Pirates.
Exactly.
Mara,
we don't know.
Mara, contract, Ogra, the boy, Ogra 50K.
Or maybe, or 90 or 100.
So, game. So, those people, they're also running a business and they contract the way they can. So,
on that note, sorry, before we go forward with other signings, because we have already touched on this salary thing, do you think it's wise to hide the player salaries, or they must just put them there?
I think
like overseas, you know, they just put them there and they're like, we know what Wayne Rooney was getting so much, David Beckham was getting so much, and so on.
I think
because of here in South Africa, we are speculating. Recently, you know, we have been speculating about Keegan Dory that he's getting $1 million. Then he's saying, no, he wasn't getting that. But Ngokwakho, do you think Mele sisibeke publicly?
Yeah, I believe or keep the way Santeri Dragona. If you want to be professionals and Renokobadiwa among the best leagues in the continent and in the world. So get the way Santeri Dragona, like the way they do things, go Football International Federation Association. So I believe the salary player, I know it's a contract, privacy, but the footballers, everybody like the real celebrities, everybody like the footballers. So I believe it's cover private, so it must be there for everyone to see.
I think,
it must be there.
Well, some of the people, they say, you can't disclose your salary, but the debt on its own, because of this is a public daily job.
And
supporters will always speculate. Also, the media will always speculate that Kamabilia is getting 800,000.
Remember, there was issue here, Bruce Rumor got 5,000.
5,000, you understand? We didn't know if it's true or not.
Yeah, politiki. We all know the MEC, the Grawakai.
Exactly.
So, those are public figures. Essentially, go bolong, even the same.
Let's hope that, you know, as time goes on, they will legalize that. They will, regulate that. So that we don't just, you know, talk about something that you don't know, because on a serious note, it's really confusing. You know, it confuses us as supporters. It also, you know, put a bad name to players who are there And Tina, as supporters, we say, we think, which I know this guy won him. But another thing that's going to be a problem is because of, is that in football, the salary scale, the gap is too much.
Yeah.
Because now, if we can know, okay, as Allende, you know,
is getting 800k. Yeah,
Allende is getting 100k. Lodge is getting 50k. How are you going to pass it? That's what happened with John Shoes Mushoi, the late, when he came from overseas, he came to Chiefs. They couldn't give him Ipoale, they couldn't pass him.
Because he was any match.
Exactly, you understand? Yeah. And even the Romas, as a Chiefs, Lodge is getting, Dole is getting 1 million, Billiard is getting 800,000, you know, Atazwan is getting 800,000. You understand?
Yeah.
Sometimes the player would get more money than the coach. And how will he listen to him? But then let's put it on to you.
Topic for another day.
But then we were still on Kaizer Chiefs. New signings. Nabi said he needs a new striker.
Yeah.
102. And he just turned down the Portugal striker.
I think he was brought by Mike Macap.
Do you think so?
Yeah, they said. Mike Macap or Kifile Chiefs striker Munyak. It's Mike Macap. Mara, I believe over Mike Macap is the one who's gatekeeping Kaizer Chiefs. I'm telling you.
Is it?
I'm telling you. I'm sorry, Mr. Mike Macap. Yeah. I'm sorry, Mr. Mike.
No need to apologize.
Erge will like a space. Or ask
him. No, he must hear you. Put it in English. We have got viewers from Botswana. Thank you very much. We have got viewers from Zimbabwe, from Nigeria, from overseas. They want to hear.
I don't want Mr. Mike Macap to kill me.
You won't. Anyway, even if you can say it in Setswana or Sesotho, they will translate it to him.
No, Mr. Remember Mike Macap, the agent of most players still or the player that I declined to take, the player that are mostly the famous most South Africa.
Yeah.
And also the big guns. So remember. Little player, what they represent, most of them, Nilkono are public, or I want to go to Chiefs.
Exactly, yeah.
And then Mike will delay the move and everything. So, going to a lorry, we all know.
I wonder why.
This agent, my brother, the Ralka rule in terms of gatekeeper, this players were good Chiefs. So, going to a lorry.
Is it because of maybe they want more money for
they
themselves?
They want more money because they know Chiefs as money. Mm-hmm. So, get that thing, lorry, obviously. I got no Chiefs Unida signing on via 1 million. And Chiefs are not 12-350.
Oh yes.
So and besides that, there are a lot of issues. Una lead issue in Chile Kaizer Chiefs, which Lord get behind the scene, Lord. I don't wanna go far. So
let's hope that in our next episode you will go far. But really it's really killing
Not go Chiefs if even go Orlando Perez. Remember the issue the Real Machek, the boy from Stellenbosch.
Yeah.
Now he had issue agent. The boy was supposed to go to Orlando Pirates.
He was also fired by
Stellenbosch. And another thing, the agent Delikisha information. So some of these things and. There are a lot of things, my brother.
Let's go to Makesi FC.
I know
is the team that is close to your heart.
Team FC, this other person, Mokomone Molokoluki.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Lena is also Fenya Makesi.
Oh, yeah. Before we go to Makesi, let's just go to the comments quickly and check who's here, who's not here. Angbazi, Abangeko, if you are not here, where are you? Okay, we have got Sakile, Mr. Komo is here. We definitely get time, my brother. Nomaranja, and keep on working. Thank you very much, Bafo. Thank you very much. We'll be waiting for you. The Tabo. Where's the Tabo?
Lethabo Nonyane, a great football analyst. South African football is in good hands. Thank you very much, my brother.
Thanks my brother. My brother Lethabo.
You know, those comments are the ones who are keeping us going. Yeah? Thank you very much. Yeah?
Are you sure he's your brother or relative?
I'll just say Lethabo.
Yeah,
thank you very much for the support. Good one. All right, let's go to Jimmy Mtokwa. Good for Magesi FC. Sheikh Stadium is ready.
I saw they're renovating. Magesi is gonna host, but I don't think it's only maybe at the 57 team. That team, yeah, I grew on a team over in 57 fans.
Oh, which one is that?
I heard there's a team from Marava Stad.
Is it?
Arenal 57 fans.
Oh, okay. No.
So the magazine will play them there because it's a small stadium.
Oh, okay. right. Okay. Thank you very much, Stembi. Thank you very much, my brother. And keep on following our page. Follow this page, Ngobo 2010 Sharp Eye Channel. We are all over social media, Ngobo 2010 Sharp Eye Channel, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. We are also on YouTube, Ngobo 2010 Sharp Eye. Please make sure that, you know, you follow us there, you subscribe, you like, you share, you comment, give us any brutal comment, it's fine. We are going to learn from those comments. This is our first live show. We just tell us there if we must continue with it, and then we'll definitely make sure that we are continuing with it. But brother, let's go to Magesi. Who's the
Luki Moloko.
My home team. All the way from
She's from Lech. Yeah.
No, nice one. Okishi.
Okay.
Yeah, you must tell me.
Lucretia.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Lucretia, for tuning in. Now we are coming to your team now. stay tuned. I saw Sohota there.
Sohota, yeah. Okay. One of the biggest signings.
Yeah, let's start with the men's in Rwanda from Chippa United, Kauhele Sohota. He came as a free agent from Stellenbosch. We have Lebohang Mabocha from Sikukune. Wonder Boy Makubu, also from Sikukune. Bongani Mpandle from Cape Town City. Jacob Everson from Moroka Swallows. Give the Mutupa.
Warra
Ben from Baroka FC, Tepo Kakura, NB Lamasia FC, Limbikani Mzava became as a free agent, Silo Mutsepe from Castric Stars, Moloisane Mukele, Sikukune United, Dilano Abrahams from University of Pretoria, and Dumelo Njoti from Maritzburg United. Remember this one, just to put our viewers at ease, these are the current players that has been signed so far that we are having, and then others will keep on updating you as time goes on, because the window period is not yet closed. Who's your best signing here?
Before, remember, most of these players, they played for Coach Clinton Lassen before. Normally, when he signed players, it's like players, those who played for him before.
Yeah, it's like Dan Malasen.
Then. So far, obviously, Kawele Sohota, one of the best signings for me.
Yeah.
And he's at home, he's going to do wonders there. And obviously, the striker from Sikukuni, Wonderboy Makube, I think is one of the best strikers. And also Selo Tshepo Motsepe is gonna be force at the back, and also not forgetting this guy from Durban City, Dumelo Njoti, is gonna do well for Dikwena Chametse. Magis, they are under Khoshi Khabo Bararo at Dumelo.
Oh, perfect. I hope these boys are gonna stay
stay longer at the PSL.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
It seems like they are a good team. And yeah, I'm happy yeah, that you know they didn't come here got the playoffs. They came straight, you know, from Motsepe League. So yeah.
And remember, this team got promoted to Motsepe Championship two times, and this team was formed in 2011. Just imagine.
Yo, recently.
Yeah, and not through backdoors.
Yeah, yeah.
They got promoted straight.
Yeah.
And even last year they got promoted straight.
Mm,
so they had good technical team. Remember, they had this guy, Mr. Peter Kotrolis.
Oh yes, yes, he worked from Chiba. Yeah.
Yeah, he worked at Chiba, even Mamelodi Sundowns.
Mamelodi Sundowns.
And
also
even at Pretoria Kellys.
Mm, mm, mm.
So the guy, wherever he is, just know you are going to be promoted or you won't be relegated.
Exactly.
So
yeah.
Very, very good guy, very good technical director.
Mm.
And they just also signed Babizo Twane as an assistant coach.
Coach, yes, yes.
And
yes,
this
yes,
team, remember last season, they had the likes of Wisile Wan,
oh,
the
yes,
striker from Santos.
Yeah, yeah.
Now they just made him a DDC co-coach.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah, he's a DDC.
Can I talk to Holela? Where is he?
Currently, Tlhobiso Holela is also part of this team.
He's part of this team, yeah.
I can confirm, or but I can confirm he's part of my GC.
Yeah, I think they're building a very good team. Yeah. Wish you all the best, Makesi FC. Let's hope that, you know, you're going to come here and compete. We know other teams came here to only beat big teams and go back. So I hope that Magnesi won't come to the PSL to beat you know, the big three. And they are here also to, you know, to perform. All right. Let's go. Let's move right along. Mamelodi Sundowns.
Kabuyelo.
Ay, Kabuyelo. Okay, they have KK Kobamelo Kodisa. I saw him playing over the weekend from Reirens. Atta Sales, the one you said they are trying to
replace Sasha with him.
Can't replace Shikaba.
Shalule, never.
Never. I mean, Shalule, yeah. Also, there's Keegan Johannes from Supersport, one of the best defenders there. Aseko Duwani from Skukune, Ikram Reinas.
Yeah, yeah.
Who's your big sign?
Obviously, I believe Reinas is one of the biggest signings. Remember, he was the second top goal scorer in the league
last season. Yes.
He's got a lot of goals for. He was player of the season for Stellenbosch, top goal scorer for Stellenbosch.
Yeah.
So I believe he's one of the best signings for Mamelodi Sundowns, but I don't think he's going to fit there.
Do you think so?
I don't think he's going to fit.
Why do you think he's not going to fit?
He's more of running. He's always running, this guy. And Mamelodi Sundowns, why not have a pass? So I'm not about
the same thing as Maseko, yeah.
Yeah. So and also other signing, the big one, I think Keegan Johannes. The boy is good.
Sport, yeah.
If you want for chance, Agadlal, obviously KK, one right team of Kobamelo Godisang.
Yeah.
I think is one of the best signing for Mamelodi Sundowns.
Yeah. Let's hope that, you know, they are going to turn around. No, three first games. They didn't convince anyone. Let's hope that, you know, with this new players, they might also, you know, turn the tables. Let's go to Marumo Gallants.
Yeah.
Siwelele sa Marumo.
Batlhabane bantwa.
Yeah. I don't know which one is which.
There's Mabina Noko, there's Batlhabane bantwa.
No. I'm saying the Batlhabane bantwa. I don't know if they're going to say it's Batlhabane bantwa or Siwelele sa
Marumo. They're sticking to Siwelele sa Marumo.
Siwelele sa Marumo.
Yeah, the time they were launching the new kit there at Bluefontein, they said it's Siwelele sa Marumo. Even the kit.
Yeah, the back, yeah. Siwelele sa Marumo, yeah. Okay, let's hope that, you know, it's going to bring, you know, good football in Bloemfontein.
Yeah.
We know that it's not going to be a Bloemfontein Celtics per se until they change the name.
It won't be easy. Max Chabalala,
yeah, but they must just give him his 5 million and then what's the
individual? Oh, it's 5 million?
Yeah.
They must just pay the money. Yeah.
Maybe the municipalities, Bloemfontein, they can just do,
you know, the challenge. That name can be five million, and then I remember Kamuruka Solos, and then una lit plara jailor Celtic, yeah, the colot under the Vitola Bluefontein Celtic.
Oh yes,
so
yeah,
they'll come under that name.
Yeah, but they must just say if indeed they are owing players, they must just say, okay, we need 5 million, and then we are owing players 2 million.
Add so give us 7 million. Okay, yeah, that's good. Yeah, it makes sense.
That
makes
way
sense.
But we need Swelele, my brother.
We need Celtic, man.
Because I remember last season, Marumo Gallants came in and they took some of their games to
Bloemfontein,
and they proposed to change the name when they. I mean, this season.
Yeah.
I mean, which is the past season.
Mm.
Unfortunately, they got relegated.
And they were doing well for Confederation.
Exactly. Unfortunately, they focused for Confederation.
The guys try, the chairman, Mr. Silo, the chairman of Maru.
He is trying.
I try, the guy is trying.
Big time. Unfortunately, no, that deal didn't, it fell off. And even this season, I don't know what happened. Again, this season, that they couldn't change the name, because when as soon as you register the name with PSL, you need to keep that name for the whole season.
Yeah. And the guy said something where there are people there at Bloemfontein, they are making sure ask aggressive team. So no matter what, by twirling that same team,
yeah, the thing I get one of the reasons why they don't want him there is because of the other season he went there. He gave them few games. I think I remember I was there in Bloemfontein. They played against Sundowns first game.
Yeah, they lost.
There were a lot of fans there, and few games. Then he moved out.
Yeah.
Of Bloemfontein.
Then he went to Rustenburg.
Yeah, then he came back this season, and also you know even in 2022-2023, he didn't have Stan Black. He played in Bloemfontein, played in Polokwane, also played in Rustenburg, understand? But let's hope that you know this season is gonna stick in Bloemfontein. Daniel Msedami from Joaneng Galaxy.
I know when I say
Galaxy, young shy. Please don't. Patricio Nanget, the former Kaiser Chiefs player, also from Super Sport United. Rivaldo Prince from Commerce Nepal, Mulelo Wakata from Obit College, and Mpo Chabatani from JDR from Pretoria Mahlangeni. From my side, I see Patricia Zonang
as the big signing. Yeah,
as a big signing. Then who else?
Yeah, also Daniela Msendami, very good player. I know him very well.
Yeah,
he's not first time playing for Marumo Gallants. He played for them before, and he was under coach Randram Revoli. There, he was doing good. So I think he's one of the best signing for. Marumo, not forgetting Patu, Chetson Nange.
And I'm happy, you know, to see, you know, those teams from Motsepe.
From Motsepe Championship, you know. Yeah.
And then
I think there are more than 20 players this year.
That came to the PSL, right?
Even ABC, the boy from Apan from Zanen United, he went to Cape Town City.
Exactly. Yeah, Orlando Pirates are Paganiya
as Minyama Kenka. The Sea Robbers.
The Sea Robbers. Masiti Robbers, as if it's Barro. Okay, Gilberto from Petro di Luanda. Ethan Kell from NC Professionals. Slilo Vasebocha from Super Sport United. Dimpo Matalane from Maluba Duba FC. Bayanda Zulu from Midland Wanderers. Tuso Muleleki from Obit College, Diano van Rooye from Stellenbosch.
Yeah. The underrated Slilo Rasbocha, Iniesta. They call him Iniesta.
Iniesta, yeah.
He's always on he's always on the 80-man squad for Orlando Pirates. He's from Super Sport United. He's gonna surprise a lot of people, so he's going to play. He's one of the biggest signings.
Yeah.
Gilberto, I think he's a scam, man. So far for now.
Yeah.
Mutoko, don't kill me. Mara, Gilberto, man. No.
But I think
he was good to go Petro di Luanda, man.
Yeah.
Orlando Pirates get him young. Look at Kim Vidu. Hey, keep playing lower. All this season is going to struggle.
Struggle, ne?
I'm telling you, Gilberto is going to struggle.
Don't you think is it because of the time that he's been given?
Yeah.
Or maybe he wasn't signed by the coach. I'm not sure because the coach didn't give him much time. Even in Spain, they were playing Spain.
He didn't get enough time.
Even the first game, MTN 8, he didn't play. Second game, he didn't play. He just got a few minutes recently. But I think he's very hard on himself.
He's trying to fit in real quickly. To be honest, he's a good player. We will see.
Let's hope that he's gonna come around. Because of at Pirates there's also a lot of competition there.
You used to say
Sundowns has got a lot of competition, but Pirates. Look at also. How Maela is no longer getting a game.
And he's a team captain.
Mosibisi
is not playing. Last Kogi was on the bench. Do you understand?
Exactly.
Otladisa is not playing.
You understand?
The boy.
So I'm not sure about Marco and Jojo. Are they injured?
They are injured. Even Libiso is injured.
Oh, Libiso is injured. He got fracture.
But one of the players, I think they're going to release him, Mutetu.
The tall guy
who scored
and then we couldn't see him.
Normally,
when you score against Chiefs as a Pirates player,
it must be a breakthrough.
If
you sharp on goal against Chiefs, you draw a mistake against Chiefs.
Where's Nyawosa? Understand? it breaks you, even Ponchani, considered a soft goal.
But now he's a goalkeeper coach.
Yeah, but then he didn't play. Understand? And I think most of the I thought maybe they're gonna keep Ofori. And because of Ofori,
he's disciplined,
he's a motivator.
Yeah.
I saw him training alone. He's a free agent now. Hopefully maybe there's gonna be a team that's gonna grab him. Let's hope that he's gonna get a team. He's one of the best, goalkeepers that we have ever experienced. I remember even his team, is it Ghana?
Yeah, he's from Ghana.
Yeah,
he made a lot of mistakes in AFCON.
But he was given a chance.
Without touching
a ball at Pirates. But let's hope that he's gonna get do well.
Team, yeah.
But also, I see Diano van Rooyen.
Since they signed him, this guy Tabiso Munyane, he's been consistent. He's been playing well.
And now you know why? he's getting a chance because of Van Rooyen is immune from playing MTN. Most of the cup rules and all that. So Moyane must make sure now.
Yeah, but they have a lot of games. They're still going to play CAF Champions League.
Yeah, but remember, now you must impress.
He must impress.
Impress now. But yeah, let's hope that I like the fact that he was signed by the coach. When you're signed by the coach, definitely
you are safe.
Very safe. But Van Rooyen is going to bring a lot of experience. Also, he played very well from Stellenbosch. I just hope for like. He's gonna get his chance also. This also in Plugane City.
The Rise and Shine.
Rise and Shine. Brian Mbire from Tusker FC in Kenya. And these people, the scouts are doing their job. I can see that. And I saw Kaiser Chiefs also has got the new scout now. From Mamelodi Sundowns. Spiwe Sithole from GA Reserves. Bonkosi Dlamini, Platinum City, Raymond Daniels, Hungry Lions, Nraton Ntamane, Marumo Gallants, and Gift Maswangai.
I think the biggest signing here is Bonkosi Dlamini. He even played well against Mamelodi Sundowns. He's from Platinum City Rovers. What is signing? The rest, I can't say much about them.
Most of them we don't know. Brian Birwe. We'll see them as time goes on. Hopefully, they're gonna get the chance. Give Maswanganyi also. Ratom Tamani. Let's hope that they're gonna do well. His former team is Marumo Gallants. Remember, he played for Marumo Gallants last season. It's
Richards Bay.
They just lost their coach recently.
The Natal Rich Boys.
Coach Vilagazi went to Amazon DDC. They brought in Fezile Caba from Kumbani Classic, Sbani Kumalo, also from Kumbani, September Cite from Kaiser Chiefs, Tabiso Kudumela from Mamelodi Sundowns, Keegan Allen from Super Sport, Agusanem Tetua, I like this boy from Solos.
Yeah.
I think he's a center back, ne?
He's an anchor.
Anchor, yeah. Yeah, Sbanyoni, Tabang Sbanyoni from Mamelodi Sundowns, Ian Otieno from Zesco United. Who's your best signing?
For me, Tabang Sbanyoni. He played well, go Amatex, especially Ghana Bank Cup.
Yeah.
He played well. Obviously,
from Sundowns.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Obviously, I see Temba Sitebe is going to be a star, go Richard Bay.
Yeah.
Just
yeah.
The Chiefs was before
him. Yeah,
and he played well, Kalas Chiefs,
yeah,
high go Chiefs.
Too much, yeah. I thought they were going to keep him.
Man, I was worried.
Yeah,
I could tell man. And obviously, like said, I am Teta, what a player.
Yeah, what a player.
He's going to play there.
But don't you think Kudumela can still do it? Because you know,
He's finished.
Game time.
It's finished.
Is it?
Kudumela.
Let's wait for two.
Yeah, let's wait for hopefully 2-3 games. But for now, like sometimes these players are lazy and lifestyle and everything.
Yeah.
Not saying we're a judge or anything, but I change them.
Yeah. No, let's hope for like Utabu and then he'll give
a I invest in my game. Like, they must invest in everything in my game.
Yeah.
So, off season via my brother got work or at our Ramarasan Chuberka come back.
Yeah. No, but our Ramara. United. Siema, I'm worried. I'm not sure if these players were signed by him. Because he came in late, but hopefully, I think it's Floyd.
Yeah, I believe it's Floyd. It won't be Habal, guy.
Yeah, it won't be Habal, yeah. Okay, there's Sean Mukhaila. He came as a free agent. Mukhaila, is it the one who was
from Royal AM?
Yeah, the one was running too much. Tabang Munare from Pirates. Lloyd Kasapua from Chippa United. Wonde Tlapa from Cosmos. Jabulo Ngobo from free agent Chiefs, from Chiefs. Okay, Kelezo Makhala from Upington City.
Yeah, he was free agent.
He was a free agent.
Chiefs released him. Yeah,
They contract him basically paid him. Rebuhile Mukwane from Cape Town City, Joseph Mpanga from Highlands Park, Andy Bobwa Boyeli from Power Dynamos, Kenneth Skosan, Skosonke Langa from Pretoria University. Any surprises here?
I'm Apollo. Jabulo's gonna do well. Remember, he was the defender of the season, past two seasons.
Yeah, 2022.
Yeah, he's gonna do well. And also, Kelezo Makhala, Obunzi, Jaka, M10-8, or Akadjala. And this guy, Sean Mukhaila. I think he's one of the best signs.
Yeah, he didn't get a chance. More chance go. Go rally and hopefully he's gonna get a chance. But no, I trust Coach Siema.
Yeah, I trust him.
He's one of the good coaches there. Stellenbosch FC, of the best.
The Grips,
team in the league. They just signed Sanele Bans.
Yeah.
And I'm happy that they're giving him a chance. Eh?
Yeah.
Sanele Bans from Richards Bay, Omega Mdaga. He came as a free agent
from Chiefs DDC, but
yeah, from Chiefs, yes. Agent. Yeah. Nishono Lomjela from Chiefs Galaxy, one of the best. Brian Mandela, Onyango from Mamelodi Sundowns. Yeah, I was surprised by that move. It's been a long time coming, and actually, Cubido from
Cape Town,
Cape Town Spurs.
My brother, all these signings are the best. All the best. All these signings. But the big one is Mujela.
Yeah, Mujela.
Even Brian Mandela Onyango.
Yeah. Onyango didn't get
enough game time. Ed Marisberg is one of the best players. Even Ashley Kubido was one of the best strikers at Cape Town
Spurs.
So even Omega Mdaga is going to play there.
Everyone
is going to play there.
No, I just like to applaud, Coach Steve Barker. He signed well.
And
what I like about him is that, as we mentioned before, he's developing players and making sure, he is giving them opportunity. Can you go to the comments now? In the meantime,
yeah,
if you know them, Santi Sirati Mary, thank you very much, Sirati. Thank you for joining us. She's saying thanks for the best episode. We are learning a lot. Thank you very much.
Thanks,
thank you for your
thanks,
ear.
Sarati.
Thank you for giving us your ear. Thank you very much. Make sure that, you know, next time you also come back, and then we are definitely coming back to give you more and more and more. I see the stars here from Silo, from Soli Sinyalo, Sekals, Soli Sinyalo. Let me look at it. It's Soli. Yeah, because I'm not sure if it was supposed to be Sigals.
So, Senyala Sigals.
Hey, Brasol, please, man.
Brasol. Refugel, bro.
Yeah, thank you very much for supporting the channel, and thank you for keeping on sending the stars. Just make sure that you give us those gifts and continue, you know, to support the channel. Also, go to the YouTube channel and subscribe there. Each and every game, we are, you know, interviewing fans at the stadium and post them on YouTube. So please go there and like them, share them to your friends, and we'll definitely, you know, have the more encouragement, you know, to come back to do more videos and also do more interviews. Let's continue with our new signings, the Super Sport also. From TS Galaxy, Nico Mobi from Sekhukhune United. That was a surprise. I thought he was going to go to Sundowns. Ricardo Goss, loan from Sundowns. Vincent Pule, also one of the big surprises. I thought he was going to go to Kaizer Chiefs. Brooklyn Pohenpool from Chippa United. Takasani Mbanja from Swallows, Moroka Swallows. Kenan Aye from Niceberg in Denmark. Yes.
For me, obviously, the young boy and Richard Brooklyn Pohenpool. I saw him against Orlando Pirates first game. Yeah, last 8 years.
From Chippa, yeah.
Last 8 years, the time they were playing M10-8 last 8 game. So I even saw him last season in Chippa. Very good anchor, Pohenpool. Yeah. Another one is Bucs Sanuka from Team Sugarcane Football Club.
Yeah.
One of the best. And even Tinyiko Mobi.
Tinyiko Mobi.
The son of Coach
Ugo. You know Coach Ugo, he made that boy.
Yeah, he made him. Made him. Obviously, you can write off Vincent Pule.
Yeah, Vincent Pule, one of the best skillful players. And I was impressed, you know, to see him, you know, being so brave. Going back to Eskotin,
you want to come back alive? They
played there.
And even scored.
You know, they tried to win.
Yeah,
but, you know,
yeah.
He shut them up by scoring, even though they lost. But you know, you could see the confidence.
Yeah.
And I was also impressed by his former teammates. You
know? Yeah, I mean the
they
fans
embraced him. Mm. You know, after the match, you know, you could see that, you know, they are not. They were happy for him.
They were not bitter eggs.
Exactly.
Those bitter eggs.
Pirates, I think such things they happen. I also saw Makaringa also. They were embracing him.
He was even lucky. Makaringa was lucky.
Exactly. He was not good that much. But he really, really played a very, very good game on the first. It was a knockout.
Yeah, it was a knockout. 3-1. Team Sukasi Football Club.
Yeah. Michele Zwalo from AmaZulu. Emmanuel Say from Watanga, Liberia. Jack Bay Morris from Liberia also. Tamsanga Masia from Sekhukhune. Obalwakhe Sibande from Stellenbosch United, Stellenbosch FC. Ndiso Mbombi from JDR. Kulumani Damane from Kaizer Chiefs. Specifically, Maduna from Cape Town Spurs. All the way to Kumalo from Moroka Swallows. Who's Kulumani Damane?
He was playing for DDC.
Oh, DDC.
He was at our DDC.
Oh, the one. Is it the one who was Who was chased away?
No, that the one who was chased the away is
he scored against them.
Is Di Tejan.
Tejan scored against
Chiefs. Yeah. So the big signing for me is Sipesi Chair Maduna.
Maduna, yes.
He's a good player. Yeah, I think he played for Paris this boy.
Yeah,
and also Victor Letoalo was one of the best signing. And the boy from Sikukun United, Tamsanga Masia. One of the good players. Yeah.
Yeah, I can see here. Sibande also from Stellenbosch, you know, he really played very well, even though he fell out of favor. He's one of the players to watch. I think for now we have covered. I hope I have covered everything. But then I will also come back next week. Hopefully, maybe we'll do a podcast on Monday. But then I think we can just close off with the game Friday.
Bafana
game.
Yes.
Unfortunately, no, these games are not marketed enough.
Ish.
Understand, they're not marketed enough, you know. We saw Mapogopogo playing at the
Ellis Park
Stadium, you know.
I guess open.
Exactly. And MTN 8 was also playing the weekend. But Mapogopogo.
But the whole week it was Mapogopogo.
You understand?
Yeah.
And even so,
if you are winning, my brother,
exactly.
Everyone in Nokova associated let the winner. So
yeah, but at least Mafana, you know, they
so far they've been doing well. Yeah,
they got bronze at the AFCON. At least, you know, we supported them.
And we came back from three not winning against Zimbabwe at Bluefontein. So the spirit is still high.
Sold out affair.
Mm.
And unfortunately, you know, Chinabantu Bamnyama in Ipola elethu. Understand? And Tina Sunugu's faga with rugby.
Yeah.
You understand? Cricket, all that.
And the ATV ball.
I can remember last year, November, when Springboks won at the airport, it was full.
It was full.
Understand? And then Bafana
2019 and 2023.
Yeah, it was full. And even now, when they are playing, the stadiums are full.
Mm.
But then with soccer, it's not happening. You understand? So I hope Uchi this coming Friday
is gonna feel as good.
I'm gonna feel as good. Please, Mapagania, as usual, as you are always, you know, a full at the stadium. Make sure that you come to the stadium, and your support will be appreciated. And we also know which like you always feeling the stadium at Escotin. So just come there. Come support your boys. Smith is there. Mfugeng is also there.
Dotley is there.
Dotley is what Chiefs, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, Dotley is there.
Shigabalam Shish is there.
And Shigabala is the captain. What do you think about that?
Yeah, it's a good thing for him. Like, especially Coach Hugo Bruce after. I was believing more enough for a long time. Remember, Coach was saying Mushishi is old.
He's old, yes.
So now, for now, I surprised him a lot. Time. Especially go AFCON.
Yeah.
So, well-deserved, I think, is going to lead us. So, I'm just worried when it comes to goalkeeping department. I just believe it's time for Sipho Chaine or Agi Puven, because I can't trust Veli Motra. He was not playing.
He's in touch the ball. So,
I believe it's time for Sipho Chaine.
Sipho Chaine, ne?
Yeah,
Sipho Chaine, it's your time, boy. Make sure that you surprise everyone there who are doubting you.
Grab that chance with both hands.
Now is your chance. Ronald Willem is not there. And then I know Uchi, you'll be in the starting lineup. Don't ask me Uchi Ngaziganjan, but I know you'll be there. And make sure that you grab the chance with both your hands. And you, Mina, according to me, Sipho Chaine is our next Senzo Meiwa.
To be honest, I'm
putting pressure on him.
Uchi,
you must be our next Senzo Meiwa. You know, we love Senzo Meiwa. We love also Itumele Nkune. Those two goalkeepers, you know, has also made an impact on you, and we are happy that, you know, on Friday you will be there and you are selected by Hugo Bruce. He's going to give you the chance. Hugo Bruce will give you a chance.
Yeah.
And when I if my phone Uzayera, but if I phone is
and the Oscar GPR pressure on himself. Remember, even Ronwen Williams' first games, he conceded 5 goals against Brazil.
Brazil, yeah.
The next game, he conceded 4. The next 2, so he was conceding
a lot.
Okay, so yeah. Maruka is him now. He's nominated for Yoshin Award.
Exactly. So, thank you. So, Sipo China, make us proud, boy. We know that you know you have been waiting for this thing, and make sure that you know you do it for the for your country. And we are going to support you. I think okay, one last thing, man. We've been watching this show from Orlando Pirates where they show us, you know, the behind the scenes, you know, Zabatlali and all that, you know, the things that, you know, as supporters we didn't know. We couldn't even hear about them and all that. We'll just see action, small number, Thomas, I'm a player, Pasani, some, you know, and you know, are angry at coaches and all that without knowing. So, do you think such shows must continue? And maybe Amanyama team also, they must also follow suit, or they must just stop it, maybe because they are revealing too much or what?
Personally, I can relate to whatever is happening from the Bucs camp. College, go to the academy, and everything.
Yeah.
So players are going through a lot, my brother. Players are going through a lot. The thing Pirates did at Bucs camp is try to show people what, what players are going through, like behind the scenes. So I think other teams can do that thing. So that thing, yeah, Orlando Pirates for now, Mara. I believe for Orlando Pirates, it delay the way I want our players. They were not given to. They are going through, and like most of them, they are depressed
too much.
They are depressed. So I believe if other teams can do that thing, so it's gonna be a good thing. So I think this one is a topic for another day, Mara. Yeah, Orlando. Big up to Orlando Pirates. TV crew, so they're doing good job.
And what I like about them is that they didn't hide everything. Remember, even Erasmus.
No, nah, that thing I had scripty, those guys, babalela everything from their heart.
No, thank you very much, my brother. What's your last words to our viewers at home before we close up?
Yeah, firstly, the viewers, 2010 Sharp Eye, from na personally, Kalevoga for Lena, Elena Kualena, take your time, Ovalerina, this whole 2 hours, little Eterna Rolela about football. We are not football experts or anything. We are just talking football. We love sports. We love to engage with you. We are family. We are still starting. So please don't judge us. Don't punish us. Yes, you can criticize, you can do anything, but at the end of the day, after a closer this thing, let's be family. So guys, please, let's continue to subscribe, let's continue to like, let's go to YouTube and 2010 Sharp Eye 2010, let's subscribe, let's like. One day, Retloba Sharp. Good night, God bless, and bye-bye.
Thank you very much, my brother. And you know, I'd like to also thank you personally, you know, for being part of 2010 Sharp Eye. I know, Hori, it's been a long time, you know. You've been liking her, we come together.
It's been a long time.
And I'm just happy that, you know, finally
you've been rejecting my messages.
finally, yeah, at least you know that door has been open, and you know you didn't only use
and thanks
your
for
fingers.
The opportunity, my brother.
Yeah, you didn't only use your fingers, you also use your knees,
everything.
but now we're here,
and
as much as you know, this is our first live show. Thank you very much to everyone who tuned in. You know, myself and Iniesta, we're still going to give you more food for thoughts, and especially, you know, football and news and everything. And also, you can also come up with the topics that you would like us to, you know, to touch on. Because sometimes you might think that, you know, this is what you want, and you know, you don't want this, but whatever that you want, just tell us, and then we're going to make sure that we give it to you. And as Iniesta said, you know, this show is for you. We also have a lot of, you know, platforms for the YouTube.
YouTube channel, Ngcobo 2010 Sharp Eye channel. Just go there and subscribe. We also have this page, which is Ngcobo 2010 Sharp Eye, also on Facebook. We have got Instagram. We also have Twitter. So I think we want to rotate maybe our lives. Maybe we can also go to TikTok. You know, we don't use it that much, but we are also there. And also we are also on website www.ngcobo2010sharpeye.com. Just go there and read all the updates for each and every news, breaking news. We just update them there. And also the fans who need, you know, who to be interviewed, you know, to be profiled, you are more than welcome to just inbox me, and then I can get your photo and get your questions, and then put you on our website. So thank you very much for tuning in. This is not the last one, it's the first one, but we're still gonna continue. Thank you very much, my brother.
Thanks, my brother, for the opportunity. Sure.